أشرف المرسلين محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما. اللهم آمين. أما بعد، يقول الحق تبارك وتعالى: قل أتحاجوننا في الله وهو ربنا وربكم، ولنا أعمالنا ولكم أعمالكم، ونحن له مخلصون. In this ayah, ayah 139 in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declares that it's not for anyone individually or collectively to dictate who's upon guidance and who's not, who's to be guided and who is not to be guided. And it is not for anyone to set a criteria other than what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has clearly outlined in the previous ayat and set the role model for those who are guided, which is the model of Ibrahim alayhi salam. As he commands us, وَإِذِ ابْتَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُنَّ قَالَ إِنِّي جَاعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا. So Ibrahim alayhi salam was the imam for all mankind, and later, at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when the Quran was revealed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ثُمَّ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ أَنِ اتَّبِعْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا. Then we have revealed to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, أَنِ اتَّبِعْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا. Follow the millah of Ibrahim, the millah of the pure monotheistic religion. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these ayat is dealing with a shubha. And just to set, you know, the rules for guidance and misguidance, the overwhelming majority of people are misguided because of one of the two. The first is the shubha, means that they have an issue with the aqidah. They're building the foundation of their ideology on false criteria, on false assumptions or presumptions, just like the Israelites did when they said, نَحْنُ أَبْنَاءُ اللَّهِ وَأَحِبَّاءُ. They said, we are the children of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we are loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so no matter what we do, we are going to Jannah, if there is Jannah, according to them. And if we were to be punished for any reason whatsoever, it's only a few days, and then we end up in Jannah again. But here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is clearing this shubha, this false assumption or presumption, that it is not the case. This is not the case. The second reason why the majority of people are misguided is because of the shahwa. People like to drink, people like to fornicate, people like to do drugs, whatever the case might be, people like to make money the unlawful way, and then as a result they begin to twist the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They begin to twist the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and as a result they misguide themselves, and some people combine the two. You know, the more misguided a person is because of a shahwa, then they're going to twist their ideology. And the more misguided a person of a shubha, they're going to twist how they indulge in this life and how they fulfill their, you know, their desires and their whims in this life. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ أَتُحَاجُّونَنَا فِي اللَّهِ. In other words, you are trying to dispute with respect to how to establish lineage with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by claiming that you are the children of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you are the loved ones. وَهُوَ رَبُّنَا وَرَبُّكُمْ. The Rabb, as we said, is the creator, the sustainer, the cherisher. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, so long that He is the Rabb, the creator, the one who brought everyone and everything into existence, أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرُ. Meaning that all creation belongs to Him, and all matters belong to Him, before, now, and thereafter. وَهُوَ رَبُّنَا وَرَبُّكُمْ. He is our Rabb, and He is your Rabb. This is an undisputed fact. Even them, they do not dispute that. In spite of the fact that the Jews have attributed a son to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ عُزَيْرٌ ابْنُ اللَّهِ, and the Christians have attributed a son to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَقَالَتِ النَّصَارَى الْمَسِيحُ ابْنُ اللَّهِ وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, and both of them are wrong. Of course, in the previous ayat they said, وَقَالُوا كُونُوا هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارَى تَهْتَدُوا. Be Jews or Christians, you shall be guided. But in the ayah that follows, we're going to see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is bringing them to account. أَمْ تَقُولُونَ إِنَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ وَالْأَسْبَاطِ كَانُوا هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارًا. So your forefathers, your ancestors, that you try to claim lineage to them, were they Jews or Christians? Because they were neither Jews nor Christians. Because Musa alayhi salam was not sent yet, and Isa alayhi salam was not sent yet. So they couldn't have possibly been, I'm talking about here Ibrahim Ismail, Ishaq, Ya'qub, and Al-Asbat, they couldn't have possibly been Jews or Christians. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah says, قُلْ أَتُحَاجُّونَنَا فِي اللَّهِ وَهُوَ رَبُّنَا وَرَبُّكُمْ وَلَنَا أَعْمَالُنَا وَلَكُمْ أَعْمَالُكُمْ. We have our deeds and you have your deeds. So we're equal here in terms of each one of us and every sect of us is going to be held accountable to their deeds. So there is no special lineage with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that is not based on obedience, based on good deeds and the righteousness of the nafs. وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُخْلِصُونَ. Here's the advantage that we have over them, inshaAllah. And that is the ikhlas, that we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with utmost purity and sincerity. Ikhlas that neither the angels can write down, because the angels have no knowledge of how the level of ikhlas, the level of sincerity and purity of worship that we have with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They judge by the way of what they see. This person is praying, this person is fasting, this person is giving sadaqah fi sabillah. But they cannot see into the heart of a person to see if this person is a mukhlas or not mukhlas. This person is a mukhlas. So the angels cannot write that down. Neither Satan can interfere with the purity of your intention. Neither Satan can corrupt that. Ikhlas is a secret that we have between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the one and the only one, يَعْلَمُ السِّرَّ وَأَخْفَى, that knows the secret and that which is more hidden, meaning that the passing thoughts inside the mind. That which the heart conceals and no one has the ability to look into it. So, وَلَنَا أَعْمَالُنَا وَلَكُمْ أَعْمَالُكُمْ وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُخْلِصُونَ. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us as the fruits of our ibadah, as the fruits of our deeds. It is the ikhlas that all of this ibadah that we've been commanded to dispose to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be it the deeds of the heart, the deeds of the tongue, or the deeds of the rest of the limbs, with utmost purity and sincerity for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just a word of caution for us here. Oftentimes we say, we have this masjid because of the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the community. This statement is an act of shirk. This statement is an act of shirk. The word and, literally translated to Arabic, means wa, the letter wa. So a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said, O Prophet of Allah, yani whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands, ma amar Allahu wa amart. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded, and you've commanded. He said, أَجَعَلْتَنِي نِدًّا لِلَّهِ. You've made me an equal partner to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the right thing to say, مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ أَمَرْتْ. Meaning that whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded, and then you commanded. So we want to make, just to correct ourselves when we make such statements, is that if you want to say to a person, I'm grateful, for the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and instead of saying, and your help, then say, and then your help. بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ, with the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then your fadl. Okay, with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the help of the community. In other words, the help of the community, the success of the help of the community came as a result of the success of the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we cannot make a nid to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to be careful just about how we phrase, things. أَمْ تَقُولُونَ إِنَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَاعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ وَالْأَسْبَاطَ كَانُوا هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارَى قُلْ أَأَنْتُمْ أَعْلَمُ أَمِ اللَّهِ. And then you would say that Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ismail, Ishaq, Ya'qub, and the Asbat were Jews or Christians. Ask them, أَأَنْتُمْ أَعْلَمُ أَمِ اللَّهِ. Do you know better? Or does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala know better? You were not even there at the time they were given the message. And they delivered the message, and they passed away, and you still have not been created yet. So these people have died in a state of Islam, in a state of the purity of Tawheed, which you have no knowledge of. Okay? قُلْ أَنْتُمْ أَعْلَمُ أَمِ اللَّهِ أَمْ تَقُولُ قُلْ أَنْتُمْ أَعْلَمُ أَمِ اللَّهِ وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ كَتَمَ شَهَادَةً عِنْدَهُ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَمَا اللَّهُ بِغَافِلٍ عَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ. And who is more of an oppressor, a transgressor, than one conceals a testimony? And what more of a conceal of a testimony that the Israelites at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, as they had wars between their tribes and wars with the Arabs and so on and so forth, that they would say, we are waiting for a prophet to come who is going to make us victorious over you. And we have a clear and meticulous description of who this prophet is. Huh? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَعْرِفُونَهُ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ. That the description that is mentioned in the Torah, the Old Testament, that there is such a detailed description of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that it makes them more aware of who the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is than they're more aware of their own children. In other words, they know this Prophet more than they know their own children. So therefore, when this Prophet came from the lineage of Ismail alayhi salam, they were not happy with that. They wanted the Prophet as if they are dictating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who the Prophet should be and what race he should come from and what description and so on and so forth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and who is more of an oppressor, an unjust person, than one who would conceal a testimony? وَمَا اللَّهُ بِغَافِلٍ عَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed is not oblivious to that which you plot, to that which you do. The final ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, تِلْكَ أُمَّةٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ لَهَا مَا كَسَبَتْ وَلَكُمْ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ وَلَا تُسْأَلُونَ عَمَّا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. This is a nation, an ummah, that has perished. To it, that which it had earned, and to you, what you have earned. And you shall not be asked about, you know, their deeds, and they shall not be asked about your deeds. What this ayah alludes to is the fact that we as Muslims sometimes adopt the same behavior the Israelites adopted. Is that we think of ourselves, we're the only ones who are guided. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is our prophet. The Jannah belongs to us. So therefore, whatever we do, we're going to be excused. Inna Allah ghafoorun rahim. So in spite of the fact that we are upon manifest error in many respects, and the ummah, a large part of it, we do not even have one Muslim country on the face of the earth that leads according to the Sharia. We do not have one land on the face of the earth that we can say the supreme power of this land is a Muslim ruler or is a khilafah or some sort of Muslim legislation. And we follow, by way of our deeds, we follow as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam predicted, لَتَتَّبِعُنَّ سُنَنَ مِنْ قَبْلَكُمْ شِبْرًا بِشِبْرٍ ذِرَاعًا بِذِرَاعٍ. You shall follow the sunan, the ways of life of those who preceded you. The expression is in meticulous details. شِبْرًا بِشِبْرٍ, like a hand length, and ذِرَاعًا بِذِرَاعٍ is an arm length, meaning that you shall follow them and copy them. Even if they enter the hole of a lizard, you will follow them and you will enter that hole. What do you see now in the Muslim world? We see that just like a very fine copy of everything the Western world does. As if we no longer take pride of our deen, as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already guaranteed Jannah for us, that no matter what we do, Jannah is guaranteed for us. But the fact of the matter, unless we go back to the source, unless we go back to the Quran and the Sunnah, unless we follow what's in the Quran and we follow the role model of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, unless we practice this ideology of infinite obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we're going to be misguided. The only way that the Sahaba and the Tabi'een were guided and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given them his testimony, his divine testimony from above seven heavens, when he says, رِجَالٌ صَدَقُوا مَا عَاهَدُوا اللَّهَ عَلَيْهِ مِنْهُمْ مَنْ قَضَى نَحْبَهُ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَنْتَظِرْ وَمَا بَدَّلُوا تَبْدِيلًا. Men of true character, their manhood is not measured by their masculinity, but rather it's measured by the level of obedience and conviction and the level of commitment to Islam and the message of Islam. The way they purified themselves, as a result, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted them victory and made them pioneers in every aspect of life. They were leaders for this ummah. They were leaders for the world. So therefore, for us to always talk about the past and our forefathers and this and that and forget that we need to follow them, not just speak highly of them. In other words, Ibrahim alayhi salam was the imam for everybody. However, his father Azar was not forgiven because Ibrahim alayhi salam was an imam. Similarly, Nuh was known to be the second father of this humanity. But his son was not forgiven because he was the son of the second father of humanity. He was the son of one of the mighty, you know, prophets and messengers. So therefore, because Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is Sayyidu Bani Adam, he's the master of the children of Adam, he's the sealed prophet, he's our prophet, and proudly so, we are proud that he is our prophet. We need to show our level of love and commitment to him and to Islam by following him and follow his sunnah in order for us to have the level of deeds and the level of sincerity and the level of commitment that is acceptable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that on Judgment Day he is given permission to intercede on our behalf. هذا والله تعالى أعلى وأعلم سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين جزاكم الله خيرا السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.